So this is an example of a geo fixture, and in this fixture floor assembly is being welded. So if you could see, like, we have different parts that are being assembled together. This is one part, one assembly. Okay, these points are actually the spot marks where the spotting will be done. Okay, see, so one part of the assembly. This is another part of the assembly. This is main part, main floor. This is one part. Then this is one part of the assembly. This is one part of the assembly. Same goes this and this. So if you could see, we have like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, somewhere 9 to 10 parts that are being welded together in this fixture. Now, like, different OEMs or different suppliers, they have different set of standards for designing their fixture. Like for this one, we are using a cylinder of this sort. This is called swivel type clamping. And in India, most OEMs use such clamping system. So this is called swivel type clamping system. Talk about another fixture. So this is another geo fixture. Now here you could see the clamping cylinders and clamping mechanism is quite different, as these cylinders are called power clamp cylinders. And these are basically used in European OEMs. In India, not all the OEMs use or prefer such clamping system as of now. So basic difference in these two are, I'll be explaining this while we'll start designing about the fixtures and the units, just to brief about you these things. The basic fixture is that, like, in this system, if you're talking about this clamping system, this is the pivot point. This whole system, whole clamping system, will rotate about this particular axis. So this is the pivot system. So we can actually change the pivot system as per our requirement, because on the pivot, I'll explain this also, on the pivot, the opening and closing of the clamping will be done. That needs to be checked. So in this, the pivot, and this is a stroke based cylinder, it will work on the strokes. So it will go up to 100, it will open up 100, and we'll have to check while it is closing up 100 mm. So this should be properly open about this axis, and this will be properly open on this thing, so that my panel could come out. If you're talking about the power clamp cylinders, this is quite easy. It has a variation of 15 degrees. Like if you've seen this one, so this is the closed condition, this is the open condition of the clamp arm, right? So if you're talking about this, it means it has a variation of frequency of or indexing of 15 degrees. So this is zero. From zero, it can go up to 90 or 135 degrees. Depends on different cylinder, different pressing of the clamp. Like if I'll say, let's say if we have to move this one. Okay, this is my clamp arm. Okay, I will select the axis. Okay, now we have to check the opening. So we'll have to rotate through axis W. In W axis, we'll provide 15 degrees, and we'll rotate. So in this direction. So this is 1, this is 2, 3, means 45 degrees, 60 degrees, 75 degrees, 90. This is 90 degree position. Then 105 degrees, 120 degrees, and 135 degrees. This is the last position. So this cylinder is happening. So we can actually control this rotation manually. So they have this some screwing system through which we can control, like, up to what angle it should go. Should it go up till 135 degrees, or should it stop at 90 degrees, or should it stop at 60 degrees? We are detailing that particular unit, so we have to define this, how much opening is required accordingly. While doing the assembly of this, the operator will adjust the setting up to 90 degrees or 60 degrees, or whatever the requirement is. So this is a basic fixture unit. Now we have a pin unit. Okay, This is a pin unit, so we have a pin here. This is the riser. We'll be getting to know about different units, different parts of units much in a much broader way, just for the view, for your understanding, to get through the terms and the terminologies, understandings. So just keep those things, and I will be explaining in the next sessions. So this is our fixtures, geo spot fixtures. Now there was one point, like geo pin will be of closer tolerance, that is -0.15 in general. What it implies is, let's say if we are talking about this car panel, now it will have this will hold, this pins will go into holes of this car panel, like this hole is there. Okay, now in 3D or in 2D you will see, because it is designer, we don't get manufacturing defects in designing. So here it will show like the dimension being X, or let's say 20 mm, the dimension is the 20 mm of this hole. So theoretically we should design a pin which will be of size of 30 mm, or we should manufacture a pin which will be a size of 30 mm, 20 mm, whatever will be the size of that hole. But we do not practice that. Like in designing, we'll go with the same dimension as the size of the hole. Like if it is 20, we'll go with 20. If it is 30, we'll go with 30. When we are going to manufacture that particular pin, we will have to consider some manufacturing defects. What happened? These holes, they are cut out from dies and stampings and all. So when you cut it, it will leave some edges and rough marks and rough patterns on the edges. Like if you're talking about a paper, if you know you hold a paper, you'll a finger or any pin or pencil or pen, you will see there'll be, it will create a hole, but there will be some extra or irregular surfaces around the edge of that hole. That won't be a lot, but it will be enough to consider it into tolerance. So that is why whenever we manufacture pin for sheet metal hole, for even for geometric positioning and geometric fixtures, we try to get that pin undersized from that particular hole. So if you're talking about a geofixer, is very precise fixture, because the geometric should be very accurate as per design and as per the relative dimensions. So it means that we need to be very precise with geofixer. So tolerance level in all terms should be very less in geofixer and also in checking fixture. So now we are talking about the geofixer. Pins should be undersized. So as mentioned here, as you could see, the pin tolerance for a geo pin will be closer tolerance, that is -0.15 in general. Consider panel hole size 20 mm. The pin diameter should be 19.85 mm. It means if the hole size of the panel is 20 mm, and when we are manufacturing that pin, the pin diameter should be somewhere around 19.85 mm. But we don't show 19.85 while designing. While we are designing the pin, we will have to go with 20 mm. Now when we will detail it, because 0.15 is a tolerance, this is not a dimension of that pin. Okay, this is basic tolerance. So while detailing, we'll mention the diameter as 20 and with tolerance level of 0 to -0.15. So this was the geo station. Now if you're talking about the respot stations, so a respot tool is a fixture in which the remaining weld spots which are not achieved in geo tool are welded for the pre-welded panel from the geo tool. As I have already explained, a respot tools are those tools where the missed out, that the spots or the weld points that we have not considered for geo stations or geo tools are to be welded here, are to be joined here to incorporate the loss of idle time of the stations or increase the cycle time of stations. Okay, now here you could see the pin tolerance for a respot pin will be of tolerance of -0.28 in general. It is less precise as compared to geo fixer. The reason being, it is not forming the geometry of that assembly. It is just spotting the remaining spots so that assembly could get the particular strength and stiffness and rigidity. It does not have to do anything with defining the geometry of that assembly. So like considering a hole size of 20 mm, the pin diameter will be around 19.72. Now marriage or hemming tool, as I have already explained, marriage tool is a station or a tool where side bodies or under bodies and front bodies are to be welded or framed together, and that can go for framer tool where the roof will come and that will be joined together. Now at hemming station, what hemming is a process that is not very much required, and like in all assemblies of a car panel, there are some specific assemblies like the hood assemblies, the door panel assemblies. Now, if you're talking about the hood or the door panel, so there are two sections, okay? One interior section, one exterior or outer section. So what happens on the edges of the outer section? It will envelop the interior section. If you could see a car or something, you could see on the door edges that there will be overlapping of the side edges of outer surface of the car door onto the inner surface. So that bending off is called as hemming process. We'll see a pictorial representation in when we'll be discussing in our next session about the joining processes of BIW welding parts. Now moving on to the checking station. So a checking station tool is a fixture which is used to check the automotive parts or assemblies, ensuring all the coordinates, relative dimensions and position as per the tolerances. A checking station can be a gauge type, fixed type and automated checking fixtures. As I've told earlier also, the checking stations are or checking fixtures or checking tools are those where you check the dimensions, you check the coordinates, you check the relative dimensions and the quality of that particular assembly, whether it is okay or not. We are not, and with different types of gauges, the different gauges, the infixture gauges or some external gauges, whether the dimensions are as per the dimensions that and the tolerances that are provided by the design team or the design of that particular assembly. So it can be of different types, can be of gauge type, a fixed type or automatic checking fixture. A gauge type is the checking gauge tool where workpiece is held and various measuring gauges are. So it is like workpiece is held, like gauges are those sort of, for example, there is an assembly A. If you're talking about, let's say about the floor panel that we have just considered, okay, like this. So let's say it is a checking fixture. It won't have that much of clamping and everything. So what will happen? I'll just fix this whole assembly with these two pin position and I will give some clamp. Now, what I have to check whether all these assemblies, the remaining small parts, child parts are relative to each other or not, or to this, because this should be maintained properly. So here I will give a fixed pin. Here for these checking, these profiles or these holes will provide with some gauges. So the operator will fix, clamp, and now it will check if the gauge is properly inserting those holes. It means my assembly is properly done. If it's not, so he will check in which direction it has moved. So he will correct that issue in the geo fixture, and again he will produce one part, manufacture one part, and again it will check. Once it is done, it is approved. It means the fixture is okay now and the quality of the assembly is being maintained. So there is a gauge type where the workpiece is being held and you do checking through gauge system. Second is a fixed type checking fixture where the workpiece is fixed with clamps and pins and a CMM machine is used which measures the coordinates of the different points of the assembly or panel and compares it with the nominal values and gives a report. First of all, what is a CMM? CMM is a coordinate measuring machine. It is a machine, very precise machine. With the help of CAD data, it checks different coordinates on the real-time zone. So like if I'm having a fixture or if I'm having a panel, so car assembly. So I'll have a CAD data of that particular car assembly. Now if I have to, let's say, check positions, like whether this assembly is in accordance or in relative with these holes or not, or this hole or not. So what I'll do, I'll check with my 3D coordinate and I'll give this coordinate some XYZ coordinate as per the design. Now I will go on and check this coordinate. So CMM machine basically has a pointed ball type tip. Okay, on that tip, it when we will touch, it will form a surface. It can form a, if we're talking 3 points in circular format, 3 or 4 points like this point, this point, this point and not this point. So it will detect, okay, it is a circle. Now 4 points are the circle, has a center, this is a center, and it will give coordinates of that center. That center you can compare with the one that is given in the design in the CAD model. If any deviation is there, it will be generated in the report. Like it will go, like if we're talking about this, so this is our y axis. Okay, so if it says it is plus 0.2 mm in y axis, it should, like the coordinate in Y should be 100. Now it comes 100.2. It means it is 0.2 mm on the positive side of Y. So we need to take it on this side. So there is an issue in the assembly, in the fixture. So a fixture, because the geo fixture has done the assembly of this assembly, right? So it means this part is locating at wrong position in the geo fixture. So we'll go back to the geo fixture. We'll rectify it. We'll do the CMM of that fixture, we'll rectify it. Okay, now it should give that assembly at not 0.2 but at that 100 coordinate only of phi. So that will be a fixed type. Now automated checking fixture is a fixture where automatic settings are being done through sensors and PLCs and switches and everything, lights and rays. When there a part will be missing, it will detect and give us the signal that particular part is missing. When a part is moved to some different positions, when the hole is mismatching and anything is being done, that can be rectified through lasering system or various means through automated system. Mostly used are fixed type checking fixture and checking gauges. Automated checking fixture are considered to be very costly. That is why we avoid going for automated, because it does not make very huge difference between checking fixture, a fixed type checking fixture, automated system. A gripper is a device or fixture which holds the car panel and is fixed to the manipulating end of a robot or an end effector. So gripper is basically a fixture but with lesser part, with lesser weight. Okay, so we always tend to keep our gripper as lower weight as possible, because it has to be mounted on the arm of a robot or some end effector, some servo system. Okay, so the weight needs to be kept very low. Okay, so that is why we use frame instead of plates, as we do in the case of fixtures. We use individual plates, localized plates and frames and etc. We try to keep it as sturdy as possible and as light as possible. So there can be different types of grippers. Like one is material handling gripper. So material handling grippers are designed for handling the car panel from one tool to another tool. As I told earlier also, the basic motive of the material handling tool is it will pick the car panel from one station and it will drop car panel to another station. Now process gripper. Process gripper designed for handling the car panel from one station to another station, and in addition to that, it undergoes process like pedestal welding, pedestal riveting, gluing. Okay, in process gripper, what happened? A gripper will pick a panel or an assembly from station A. It will go to some pedestal stands, pedestal welding stand, pedestal gluing stand or riveting stand. So there will be a pedestal fixed stand where a gun will be mounted, a gluing gun or riveting gun or spotting gun, and the gripper will take that assembly or that panel below those guns, will orient in specified directions or positions of the spot, and the spotting or gluing will be done on that particular assembly, and then it will drop to station B for further processes. So this is called a process gripper. So a gripper is doing some process. It is also welding or gluing that particular assembly before unloading it to some other station. Combo gripper designed for handling the car panel from one tool to another tool, also with a combination of weld gun at the other side of the gripper or for welding. So a combo gripper is a gripper where it will be picking a car panel from one station to another station, and also it is incorporating a gun. So once it has picked and dropped, it will rotate and start spotting or welding and gluing, whatever the process needs to be done. That is a combo gripper. Dual gripper. Dual gripper are designed for handling the car panel from one tool to another tool with two-sided gripper. So it is actually designed for handling the car panel from one station to another station with two-sided grippers. Means it can hold two panels simultaneously. So it is going to station 1, station A, pick a panel. It generally happens where, like, we are talking about the side bodies, like where the symmetry of cars are there. We need a set of bodies together to be assembled at some places, majorly at those spaces. So gripper will go to station LH side. It will pick the LH side of a part. It will go to the RH side, it will pick the RH, and then it will go to the center mainline assembly and will drop to the fixture, and the assemblies will be done. Now different types of stands are there. First, the gluing in the sealer stand. Gluing gun or sealer gun is fixed to a welded or a standard stand which is grouted to the floor permanently. So if you could see, this is a gluing stand. So it is a welded or standard stand that is fixed to the floor permanently. Fixing to the floor is very much required because it, due to vibrations or in the plants or other factors, it should not move. This stand should not move in any direction, because even it moves 1 mm, 2 mm over a period, and let's say after an year or 2 years, this stand tend to move due to vibrations. Every day it was moving 0.1 mm, 0.1 mm, 0.1 mm, which is very slow, and after an year it came to notice that it moved around 2 to 3 mm. So now if my gluing has to start with coordinate at x is equal to 100, now this has moved at 2 mm, so my gluing will start at x is equal to 102 or 98, right? So this is one gluing and sealer stand. So that is why it needs to be fixed permanently to the ground. So what happens, it will be connected to some in-fit gluing system. This nozzle, the gluing will come when the robot